Hello, and welcome. Let's take a look at how this week went. Week 3 with Oslo and Paris, who's itchy apparently. Let's begin.
Sunday started again, of course, with lots of playing.
No.
Eating straw right from the bale, being crazy, and of course, making a big mess. I have to be careful because sometimes they run and play so much that they get super out of breath. But they have so much fun, so it's okay. Sunday, I also caught a glimpse of Paris chewing her cup. They regurgitate the contents of the first part of their stomach, or the ruminant, hence the name ruminant, chew it and then re-swallow it. All ruminants do it, and it's a sign that they're relaxed. And of course, Ozzy sniffed me. I'm so glad I was able to give them a stall with a spot to look out of because I do seem to love looking around. I feed my sheep extra free choice minerals. It's like a reddish-orange powder that I just put in a feed dish for them. And as you can tell by the pictures, they absolutely love it. Although, sometimes they wear more and eat it. And they do have a lot of fun dumping it. And our barn kitten is back. Ozzy and Paris got to meet Petey. The day after Oslo and Paris got here, the three barn kittens were gone for 2 weeks because the two big girls had to give. If they were the same size, they'd make great friends because red, blue, purple Dalaran are just as cute, sweet, and playful as Oslo and Paris. While I was cleaning their stall, my horse was so jealous because I'm pretty sure he thinks the straw I'm cleaning up is actually hay. So funny. This time I used the wagon that goes on the Kubota so they didn't get to dump the buckets. They still jumped in and out of it, though, and had a ball running around the barn. I'm pretty sure Paris sometimes thinks she's a bird, not a sheep. Even when I'm working her.
But you're letting her do
my
it.
My mom was holding on to her while I was working Oslo.
What if Okie were
and this is what she was doing.
On the lead rope.
Of course it's adorable, but she can't do that in the show ring when I'm only holding on to her by a hand under her jaw. So I'll have to train her out of that. They have been doing very well working. I've been able to start by handling them with just my hands, although I still have the halter on. I've been working on setting and bracing a bit, too. Since they're not always going to be together, I've also been starting to work them separately. I'll pull one out and leave the other in the stall. They're not too happy with me when I do it, but they act completely different. Paris is completely fine walking away from Oslo as long as I'm with her, but if Oslo leaves her, she's not a happy camper. Where Oslo's a bit hesitant to leave Paris. He'll normally walk completely fine, but as soon as she starts to baa for him, he stops dead in his tracks and tries to go get her. When I work them alone, I only stay in the barn. That way, if they start to freak out too much, I can let them sniff each other so they know they're okay, and we don't have any dead sheep of heart attacks or feet stuck in the chicken wire. I didn't get to take many pictures or videos of them this week, but I did find time to do a book photo shoot. I absolutely love reading, so I submitted their picture to a local library for a bookmark photo pet contest. They got to learn about photography, and then they got to read about miniature horses. But unfortunately, they didn't quite seem to grasp the concept that the book is not a pedestal, nor is it a snack.
Of course, all my other animals, like Marty Man, who jumped over the same book the lambs read, and Hershey, Jekyll, Georgia, and Ezzy, are all four of my rabbits.
And Chili, my chinchilla, who I don't think I've introduced to you yet. He loves when I come home and smell like all the farm animals. The sheep have given him a new scent, and he's enjoying it.
I only got a chance to weigh tape them once. Ozzy was 86.2 pounds, and Paris was 68 pounds. Based on what they weighed on the actual scale, I feel like these numbers are definitely a bit high. Remember, weight taping is just a rough estimate.
Okay.
And because they weighed less, actually, than what they weight taped, my app now thinks they're losing weight, as seen on screen now. So, that was our week.
Thank you so much for watching this video today. I hope you enjoyed it and find Oslo and Paris as adorable as I do. Again, I really appreciate your interest in me and 4-H and your support for 4-H and so many other amazing youth. With that being said, if you want to learn more about who we 4-H'ers are and what we 4-H'ers do, be sure to check out all the other videos on my YouTube account. Again, thanks for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll update you next week. Bye!